In a previous video, I went over how to use the regular subtraction algorithm. In this video, I want to go over how and why a regular algorithm makes sense. I'll be doing this using a place value chart. In this video, I'll be looking at subtraction and the necessity of regrouping when you're asked to subtract a larger number from a smaller number in a particular place value. We'll begin by looking at the ones place. To begin, we have 650 minus 6. I've already placed 650 in my place value chart, and I want to take 6 ones away. But I can't do that because I have no ones to subtract that 6 from. Therefore, I must regroup. To regroup, what I want to do is turn this 110 into 10 ones. And so I'm going to cross out this 110 and draw an arrow to make 10 ones. Now that I have 10 ones over here from the 110, I can cross out the 6 that I want to take away. After crossing those out, I can see now that I have 4 left in the ones place. 1, 2, 3, 4. I have 4 in the tens place, and this hundreds place was never impacted, and so I still have 6 in the hundreds place. And this one, I have 610, which is represented here, minus 80. I have no number in the ones place, so the ones place is going to be unaffected. But I do want to take away 8 tens. But I can't do that because I only have 110 in the tens place. Therefore, I'm going to cross out my 100. And students should know that 100 is equal to 10 tens. Now that I've regrouped and put 10 tens in the tens place, from the 100 that I took away, I can cross out the 8 that I need to. Now I regrouped from the hundreds place, so now I only have 5 here. So now I can figure out my answer that I have 5 hundredths, 3 tens, and 0 ones. 530. In this last one, I have 2,381 represented in the place value chart, and I want to subtract 700 away from that. However, when I come to the hundreds place, I do not have enough to subtract. Therefore, I will need to regroup. Students should know that 1,000 is equal to 10 hundredths. So I'm going to put 10 disc over here. Now that I've done this, I can subtract the 7 hundredths that I need to. Now I can look at my place value chart to solve the answer. I have 1 in the thousands place. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in the hundredths place. I have 8 in the tens place and 1 in the ones place. In this video, we went over how the place value chart can help students understand how to regroup and subtract it. The goal eventually is that students would be able to solve these using the regular subtraction algorithm, which I will go over in the next video.